My name is Sierra Denniston, and I am 17, and I attend Interlochen Arts Academy in Northern Michigan. It's a boarding school for the arts. My official bipolar diagnosis was when I came home last November. This November 2013, I came home from Interlochen. I just decided that I couldn't stay because I was just, it was a downward spiral, and I got Baker acted, and then the doctor was like, wow, like no one has diagnosed you with this. I've seen so many people, and they had only said it was a mood disorder, and they officially diagnosed me with bipolar disorder, so. A lot of people, when it happens to them, it becomes important. Like me, it's happened to me and now it's important to me. And it's important that other people know that, you know, there are those people that aren't gonna understand. And instead of getting angry or trying to, you know, just you don't understand, you have to tell them. You have to at least try and explain, because it is something that is real, and it's not an excuse. It's not just, oh, you know, that person's crazy. It's a real thing, and now there's more and more research that's backing it up, and there's a lot of evidence that proves, you know, that it is not just a choice. Singing opera is my passion, and it's something that gets me out of this world, you know, in a totally amazing way. I can sing and be in my happy place, which is wonderful. It's an escape in a sense. The best way to get out of your head is to take your meds and stay on track, because then you'll be out of that mindset of the depression. You'll be in your real self, you know. The medications you're prescribed from your psychiatrist are the best drugs that there is, because you'll get what you're looking for using or taking those that you're prescribed. By using alcohol and drugs, it'll just get worse. You'll never find that release that you've been wanting. And I think, you know, that's a coping mechanism that people use because they have no way out, but it doesn't help. I mean, from firsthand experience, it really just takes you back even farther than you were. It's been a roller coaster. My essay that I wrote this summer to get back into Interlochen, it was titled "If You Could Change It All, Like Would You?" or something like that. And I went through my diagnosis. I basically described everything I had been through. And at the end, in my closing paragraph, I said, "I have been through a lot, and it hasn't been fun. You know, it's been pretty bad at a lot of points, but." In the end, this is who I am, and this has molded me into who I am. And I think that I am such a better person and more understanding and more, you know, more open to other people. And everything bad that's happened in my life has came around and showed me something good. And if you choose to look at it that way, life will be a lot easier than looking at it as, oh my gosh, you know, all of this has happened to me. And looking at it from a good light makes a world of a difference, because, you know, it's my goal in life to help people and make them understand that I've been there, you know, I've lived it. And no one should ever have to go through what people with mental disorders go through. It sucks, it's not fun, but with the right support system and the right medications, you will get through it, and you just have to believe, I guess, in whatever you choose to believe in. Just hang on to whatever it is that helps you. Thank you.